Hello student, today I am going to teach you second year computer engineering subject, that is district mathematics. In this subject, today we are going to learn graph theory. Now in this graph theory, this is the SPPU syllabus, Savitribai Phule Pune University. Chapter number is 4. Now in this graph theory, we are going to understand what are the different terminologies of the graph theory. Then what are the types of graph theory, representation of the graph, isoprismic connectivity, Pearson, Hamilton path. All these points we are going to cover. But today, my interest is that I am going to complete what is meant by the graph, definition of the graph and its type. So, let's we will see the graph introduction. This graph, first of all, we will see what is the definition of the graph. Now, the graph is a ordered pair. Graph is an ordered pair that is represented as G is equal to V comma E. G is equal to V comma E. What is mean by V and what is mean by E? So V is nothing but the vertices. V is nothing but the vertices and E is nothing but the edge. What is vertices? Suppose we have a graph. If you want to represent the graph, you can represent graph in this way. So these two circles are called as an vertices. These two circles are called as an individual vertices. Now if these two vertices, if these two vertices are connected with the help of any line, this line is called as an edge, edge of this graph. Now, this is called as an graph. Okay, this is called as an graph. Now, see here, the set V is an finite, non-empty, that is vertices, that is finite and non-empty set of vertices. And the set E is a set of pair of vertices representing the edges. Now, see here, here is a one. Edge, with the help of one edge we have connected two vertices. Now see, this is the our definition, G is equal to V comma E. Now if you want to represent the vertices in a graph theory, then V of G is equal to vertices of that particular graph and E of G is equal to, we can read as edges of that particular graph. Now we may say this is a graph and all these vertices, suppose this is A, this is B, this is C and this is D. These ABCD are the vertices and all these vertices are connected with the help of the edges. Okay, with the help of these edges. So the graph, if this is the graph, then V of this graph is equal to AB comma BD comma CD, or you can say the DC and AC. These are the edges. Okay, you can say that these are the edges and A B C D are the vertices of that particular graph. Okay, this is what about the graph. So simply, graph is obtained pair of vertices and edges. This is nothing but the graph. Now, before moving towards the in detail discussion about the types of the graph, we should understand what is mean by what are the applications of the graph. Now, the graph can be used to model many type of relations and processes. Graph can be used to model many types of relations and processes in a physical, in a biological, in a social and information system. Okay, and a information system. Let's we'll see this application. For example, the relation. Now, if you want to represent your family relation into the picture with the help of the graph, you can represent your family as in a picture. Okay, family as in a graph. And then processes in physical, for example, whatever the processes in a university, whatever the processes in a colleges, you can represent all the processes with the help of the graph. Then biological, that is a you can take the help of the biological concept, you can represent that biological things into the graph, you can represent the social things into the graph, and you can represent the information system with the help of the graph. How information we have stored, what is the source, what is the destination, where that information is collected, where it is stored, all these things we can represent with the help of the graph. And many practical problems can be represented by a graph. Now, as a second year student, you have practical labs, that data structure lab, in that so many assignments are there. If you want to represent this assignment or you want to represent the algorithm, just you are taking the help of the you are taking help of the flowchart. Flowchart is a representation of that particular algorithm in a pictorial manner. The same thing we are representing in the graph. Whatever the idea we have, we are representing that idea into the picture. So, in a computer science, what are the application? In a computer science, graphs are used to represent the network of communication. Communication. Now I am communicating with you people with the help of the YouTube. Okay, but if I want to represent these things with the help of the graph, so I can represent myself as a presenter presenting the lectures, and you are the student, you are observing my lecture or you are listening my lecture. So this network we can represent with the help of the graph. And data organizations, okay, then computational devices we can represent with the help of the graph, and the flow of computations we can represent with the help of the graph, etc. For instance, the link structure of a website can be represented by directed graph, in which the vertices represent web pages and directed edges represent the link from one page to another page. See, this is one beautiful example you are observing. The linking structure of the website. Now, we are the user. We are using the website, means we are the user. For that, if you want to retrieve some data, then you have to fire the query with the help of the search engine. So for that, website can be the represented by directed graph. Means suppose you want to access the information about the district mathematics. Okay, now you can fire the query, you can write down PPT of graph theory on the Google and search it. Now, where that PPTs are stored, that particular query is transferred towards the server. Server can search that particular query and retrieve the data, and data can be revert back to the source machine, that what machine you are using at that machine. On that pages you will see the retrieval data. So this is what about the representation. Then in similarly, the approach can be taken to problems in a social media, the traveling problem, okay, then biology, then computer chips, computer chip design, and many other fields. So in this social media, the network is most important, and we can represent that social media with help of the graph. The traveling, if you want to travel from Pune to Bombay, then you can represent that traveling structure with help of the graph. Then biological concept you can represent with help of graph. Then computer chips design you can represent with help of the graph, what are the chips and how we are going to design. Before the actual design you can draw the graph of that and you can take the approval. Okay, the development of algorithm to handle the graph is therefore the major interest in a computer science. So the with the help of this graph we are going to developing the algorithm, and with the help of the graph notations we can design the algorithm into the flowchart, and that flowchart is very easy to understand. Which command is linked with which function and all these things we are going to represent with help of the graph. So the because of this we are going to use the graph theory in a computer engineering. Now first of all, it's our prime duty to understand what are the different types of the graph. Okay, how many types are there, what are the different types of the graph, that we have to study. Now first graph, that is the null graph. We may say that the null graph is there. Yes, we can say there is a null graph. What is the definition of the null graph? A graph having no edges is called as a null graph. How you will represent? Now from this particular PPT you will actually understand how that graph theory is implemented or used in the computer science. Now see here, graph having no edges is called as a null graph. So we have the vertices like this. We may say that this is the A, this is the B, this is the C, and this is the D, but there is no edge between this A, B, C, D. So this graph is called as a null graph. Okay, understood? This is called as a null graph. Then second type, that is the travel graph. Travel graph, a graph which only one vertices is called as a travel graph. Now see, now only one vertices is there, that is for example vertices A is there, and such kind of the vertices is called as a travel graph. Then say third one is undirected graph. Now first of all, you know the graph is nothing but the G is equal to V comma E. So when we are going to call this is the graph, there should be the vertices and there should be the edges. But there is a one type, that is undirected graph, means there is no direction. So let's try to understand what it means. Before that, just you can read the definition. A non-directed graph contains edges, but the edges are not directed. They are containing the edges, but edges are not directed. How it is? We'll draw the one graph. We can draw a same graph here. Now this is called as a graph. Now, in this graph, a non-directed graph contains edges, but edges are not any directed. Now, these are the vertices and these are the edges, but these edges are not having any direction. This edges is also not having any direction. This edges is also not having any direction. This is also not having any direction. So, such direction is not there, then such a graph is called as an undirected graph. So, this is simple one. Then directed graph, what is meant by the directed graph? Exactly opposite to the undirected graph. Now, same, there is a direction from a graph. This is called as an directed graph. This is called as an directed graph. In a directed graph, each edge has a direction. Now, suppose this is the E1, this is the E2, this is the E3, and this is the E4. E4 is equal to, for example, we may say that this is the A, this is the B, and this is the C, and this is the D. Now, if you want to represent E4, then E4 is represented in this way, that is C2D, because C is contacting to the D. So arrow is at D vertices. So this is called as a directed graph. Then what is meant by the simple graph? A graph with no loop and no parallel edges is called as a simple graph. Okay, the graph with no loop and no parallel edges is called as a simple graph. So how it will be? For example, suppose we may say that this is called as a simple graph. Now here, is there any loop in this graph? No. Is there any parallel edges? No. So we can say that this is what the simple graph. Okay. So then next is the connected graph. The path between every pair of vertices Vi and Vj. Now Vi means n number of vertices are there. So Vi to Vj. So, path between every pair of vertices is called as a connected graph. Let's see. Suppose we have a structure like this, or we can say the graph like this. See here. The path between every pair of vertices Vi and Vj. Whatever the vertices you have, for example, this is A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. So every vertices, there is a path. So we can say this is nothing but the connected graph. Now, what is meant by the weighted graph? Now this weighted graph is one of the most important concept in a graph theory. So this weighted graph concept or this type of graph is used to find out the shortest path in the application. So in this, weighted graph, for example, before that we will see the path having the particular natural number. Okay, path is having the any natural number or any weight. For example, we will consider this diagram to understand. Suppose this edge is having 5, this edge is having 3, this edge is having 2, this edge is having 1. So whatever the number you are observing, this number is called as a weight of this particular edge, or sometime we can assign the weight at the vertices. For example, 5, for example, 3, for example, 2, for example, 1, in this way. So this is called as a weighted graph. Then what is mean by the cycle? Cycle means there is a direction in a graph, but graph is in a cycle structure. Suppose this is A, this is B, and this is C. A to B, B to C, and C to A is called as a cycle in a graph. Means if you are going to observe such kind of the structure in any big graph, then that is called as a cycle present in the graph. So this is what the cycle in the graph. Then next is the tree. This is again one of the most important types of the graph in a graph theory. The trees. A tree is a connected graph without any cycle. On previous slide, we have seen the cycle. Okay, we have seen the cycle. But in this trees type of the graph, there is no cycle. So first of all, we will try to draw the tree like structure. What is mean by tree? There is no cycle in a graph. So we may say that in a data structure, already you might be studied the what is mean by the tree. Okay, what is mean by the tree? So this is, we may say that this is the tree structure, but there is no cycle. Have you observing any cycle in this particular tree structure? No. Now node is not node A, B, C, D, E, F is not having any cycle. So this is called as a trees of the graph. They are not containing any cycle. So this is the basic terminology and their type of the graph. Now next type, that is the regular graph. So we will try to understand what is meant by the regular graph. So in this regular graph, a graph G is said to be regular if, now whatever the part I have highlighted, that is very important, if its vertices have the same degree, then such a graph is called as a regular graph. If all its vertices have the same degree. Now it's very interesting, what is mean by degree? Okay, what is mean by degree? So that we will see along with the diagram, along with the graph. In a graph, if the degree of each vertices is a k, that is the same degree, then graph is called as k regular graph. Now let's see, I will draw. There is no any condition of the cycle and nothing else, but only one condition is that if all its vertices have the same degree, then we can call such graph is called as a regular graph. Now what is mean by the degree? Now let's try with the example. Now see, the vertices, they are connected with the edges. All the vertices of that particular graph are connected to same number of edges, that called as a degree. Now see here, this particular, suppose this is A, this is a B, and this is a C. Now how many edges are connected to the A? This is 1 and this is 2. So this is called as a degree 2. At the same time, at vertices B, how many edges are connected? So this is 1 and this is 2, that is the degree 2. At the same time, at C, there is also degree 2. So, K is equal to 2. Means, whatever the vertices are available, are present in the graph, and all the vertices are having the same degree. Let's see one more example. This is also a regular graph, because every vertices, there are three outgoing, or we can say the incoming edges at the every vertices. But if you want to see the non-regular graph, then we can draw one structure. We can say this is the graph. Yes, this tree is a simple graph. Now, if these particular vertices are having same degree or 0 degree, this is called a regular graph. But here we can say, if here is having something structure like this, then we can say this is not a regular graph. This is not a regular graph. Now here, in this regular graph, the same concept is applicable. A simple graph with n mutual vertices is called as a complete graph, and it is denoted by K of n. It is denoted as K of n. In the graph, a vertices should have edges with all other vertices. This is the answer. Then it is called as a complete graph. Then it is called as a complete graph. Now this is a complete graph. In other words, if vertices, you can remember this sentence, if vertices is connected to all other vertices in a graph, then it is called as a complete graph. If vertices is connected to all other vertices is in a graph, it's called as a complete graph. So this is what about the complete graph. Now one more type, that is the bipartite graph. Now in this bipartite graph, let's see what is the definition of the bipartite graph. Now in a graph, G is equal to vertices and edges. G graph is nothing but collection of vertices and edges. With the vertex partitions, if we are going to divide the vertices, or we can represent the different vertices in this way, that is vertices is equal to, there are a group of the vertices. Okay, now we can represent V1 and V2. It's called bipartite graph. It's called bipartite graph if every edge of E joins a vertex in a V1 to vertex in a V2. Now here is a structure. Okay, we have partition of the vertices, and that partition is nothing but the V1 and V2. And according to this, is called a bipartite graph when if every edge of E, it joins a vertex in a V1, two vertices in a V2. Now, how many vertices in V1? 1 and 2. And how many vertices into V2? This one and this one. So, they are joins, means B is joined with D, as well as A is joined with E. This is what about the bipartite graph. Now, in general, the bipartite graph has two set of vertices. Let's say V1 and V2. And if an edge is drawn, it should connect any vertex in a V1 to any vertex of V2. That's why this structure is, you can easily understand by observing this simple structure. Okay. In this graph, you can observe two set of vertices, that V1 and V2. This one, this is the V1 and this is the V2. Here two edges named as AE. So this is the A and this is the E. This is the A and this is the E. A from V1 and E from V2. So this is called as an edge AE. And one more edge you are observing, that is the vertices set, that B to D. So this is what about the one more edge you are observing in this graph. This such graph is called as an bipartite graph. Okay, so this is one of the most type in the graph. Then without connectivity we cannot say this is the graph. So connectivity is most important to represent the graph. A graph is said to be connected if there is a path between every pair of vertices. This is very, very important. So without the connectivity we cannot say this is the graph. So connected if there is a path between every pair of vertices. So from every vertices or vertex to any other vertex, there should be some path to travels, means for move from one vertices to another vertices. That is called as a connectivity of the graph. How simple it is. So now let's take the help of this example to understand what is meant by the connectivity. This is very simple one. So one more point is remain here. A graph with multiple disconnected vertices and edges is said to be disconnected graph. For example, suppose I have one graph. Okay, if this is the graph, I can say this is the connected graph. But if I have one more graph at the same time and these two graphs are not connected, then and they are part of the same object, then at that time we can call this is an a disconnected graph. But here we can say that in this example the following graph, it is possible to travel from one vertices to any other vertices. For example, one can travel from vertex A to vertex E, vertex A to vertex E, by using the path A, B and E, A to B and B to E. Okay, so all the vertices of this graph are connected, all the edges are connected to the all the vertices. You can travel, you want to travel from A to D, then you have a choice. You can travel like this, or if graph is undirected, you can select vertices as per your convenient. You can travel from this to this. But if you have a direction like this, then you have to travel according to the direction. So first of all, you have to come here A to B, and if you want to travel to the D, then only you can come here, otherwise not, in a directed graph. So we can represent connectivity in this way, that is A to B and B to D. This is what about the connectivity. Then spanning tree. First of all, we will try to understand the definition of the spanning tree. A spanning tree of a graph, that is graph is collection of vertices and edges, is connected subgraph of G having all vertices of G and no cycle. There are two conditions in a spanning tree. Connected subgraph of all having all the vertices of G and no cycle in it. Now I will draw one graph to understand what is meant by the spanning tree. Suppose we have graph like this. These are the two subgraphs and they are connected to each other, but according to the definition there is a cycle. Okay, we can say these are the cycle. So if graph G is not connected, then there is no spanning tree. So before first of all, its very first requirement, graph should be connected graph. A graph may have multiple spanning tree. Okay, multiple spanning tree. Now according to the definition, we will try to represent this particular connected graph as a spanning tree. In this connected graph subgraph having all vertices, we should not delete any vertices. We require all vertices of a graph and no cycle. So what will be the first structure of this? There should not be a cycle. So I can represent the spanning tree in this way. So there should not be any cycle and all vertices should be covered. So I can draw this, may be the one structure. How many vertices are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all vertices are connected. So this is a one way of representing the spanning tree. So somebody say that, yes sir, I can represent our spanning tree in this way. Yes, you can represent, there is no restriction, but you have to follow the definition. Yes, there is no any cycle, so all vertices are covered, and we can say that there is no loop. Or someone may say that, yes, I can represent our structure in this way. Yes, you can draw in this way. It is also accepted. Or somebody say that, sir, I can draw our structure in this way. Yes, you can draw, because there is no any loop in this particular tree, in this particular graph. So such a graph is called as a spanning tree. So in this spanning tree there is one more concept, that is the minimal spanning tree. Now on previous slide you have seen the weighted graph. Okay, at vertices there is a positive integer number, and that number is called as a weight of that particular vertices. Let's talk about this minimal spanning tree. The cost of, now here they have used word as a cost. That cost is the sum of all weightage, that is called as a cost. The cost of a graph is sum of cost of the edges in the weighted graph. A spanning tree of a graph, that is collection of vertices and edges, is called minimal cost spanning tree, or simply the minimal spanning tree of a G if its cost is a minimum. Now we will try to understand. We will take the example of the, we may say that this is an subgraph, and this graph, suppose this is the A, this is the B, and this is the C. Now here is a 5, 2, and here is 3. Now in this way. Now there is a cycle. In this graph, you are observing the cycle. Now this particular graph we have to convert into the minimal panning tree. Now you know that how to convert into the panning tree, and after that we can say which one is the minimal panning tree. So we'll try to represent our graph into the panning tree. So I have one option. I can select this. I can select this one. Yes, all vertices are covered. Yes, my condition is satisfied. A, B, C, and this is the 3. So all vertices. So what is A, B? The weight is 3 plus what is the B, C? Their weight is nothing but the, sorry, AB is the 5 and is a 3. So we can say that 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. Now you can represent your graph in this way to traverse. So here is a A, here is a C, and here is a B, and their weightage, here was a 2 and here was a 3, and you can similarly add this weight, that is the 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. So I can say that this is an minimal tree. Yes or no? But I have one more option, that is I can draw this tree in this way. So this is A, this is C, and this is B, and here is a 2 and here is a 5. So 5 plus 2 is equal to 7. So which one is the minimal cost? The 5 is the minimal cost. So with the help of this, you want to travel, visit all the nodes, then you can start from A to C and C to B, and their cost is 5. You cannot start because their cost is more than this. Here cost of this and cost of this is more than cost of this. So this is called as a minimal panning tree. So this is what I want to discuss in today's lecture. So thank you for watching my lecture.